Bhatia, and today we are going to discuss what is high functioning autism. High functioning autism basically relates to autism cases where there is no associated intellectual disability. Now, intellectual disability is defined as people having an IQ less than 70. Most people have IQ in the range of 70 to 130. IQ above 130 is for people who are exceptionally gifted, and whenever there is IQ less than 70, it is termed as intellectual disability. So majority of autistic children show some kind of intellectual disability too, but there are certain cases where there are deficits in the area of communication, there are deficits in the area of emotional recognition and emotional expression, and there are deficits in language development. But despite these deficits, there is no intellectual disability. The child is able to perform normally. There is no associated mental deficit. The learning is not inhibited. The expression is not inhibited. The language development is delayed. But the child can learn whatever is being taught to the child, and the child can express. In fact, some of these children are highly gifted. They can be very skilled in one particular area. Now, that skill set can vary from one child to another. This high functioning autism is very, very similar to Asperger's syndrome. In fact, Asperger's and high functioning autism, there is no clear cut demarcation. It's the difference is in the degrees. The primary difference that we see in Asperger's and high functioning autism is that in high functioning autism, the language development is usually delayed till post 3. In Asperger's, there is a generalized language developmental delay. The children who have high functioning autism, they are more curious. They can learn more compared to Asperger's syndrome. The children who have high functioning autism, they are less clumsy. They are less clumsy and they have less spatial problems. But they also show less empathy as compared to Asperger's. So these are some very basic differences between high functioning autism, which we call HFA, and Asperger's. Please remember that both high functioning autism and Asperger's are not a clinical diagnosis anymore. They are clubbed as part of the autism spectrum disorder. So this is high functioning autism for you. And the children with high functioning autism have usually better prognosis compared to other autistic children. And the learning and treatment methods also are slightly different. The language acquisition part is dealt with other methodologies. Special learning techniques are involved with these children. The generalized treatment remains same. The behavioral therapy, occupational therapy, dietary supplements, and sensory therapy, all these work for high functioning autism children also, but the learning methods can slightly vary. Thank you.